You are now listening to the Walk by Faith podcast. I'm your host, Jasmine Stith, aka The Pretty Plug. I'm on a mission to tell the lost story that combines faith in God and success here on this earth. The world often separates faith and entrepreneurship as if, y'all, as if it was mutually exclusive. But I assure you it's not. I interview the following types of people: entrepreneurs, business women and business men climbing the corporate ladder, founders of nonprofit organizations, college students following their passions, and also artists on the rise. They are movers and shakers in this generation, and I intend to plug you in week after week with content that inspires and educates you to be all that you are called to be. Thank you for tuning in, and now for this week's episode. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the 46th episode on the Walk by Faith show. This episode is brought to you by Faith Tech Grow LLC, a company focused on developing and cultivating entrepreneurs and professionals by providing education, resources, connections, and digital marketing to increase their leads and sales to their business. We also make sure that at Faith Tech Grow, you make sure that faith is the secret sauce to create and sustain your business and each other. We have some shirts that you can sell. Please click the link in the bio to get yours today. The website, in case you don't click the link, is www.shopfaithtechgrow.com. The password is faith. And again, you are an exclusive member to the Walk by Faith family. So that means, hey, I'm going to give you free shipping. The shirt was normally $25. You're getting it for $20. And it's coming to you right at your doorstep with the help of Brianna Coleman, who ships our shirts right to your door. I just want you to know that I'm so thankful for each of you that tune in week after week to the show. Thank you for supporting it on social media. Thanks for buying shirts. Thanks for purchasing tickets to events. I am so thankful for your support. Now, if I could get you to do one thing, which is go and actually review the podcast, give it a 5-star rating, and let me know how we're doing with the Walk by Faith team. You can also go to Instagram and follow us at wbfpodcast and Faith Tech Grow. That way, you don't miss out on anything. But because you listen to the podcast, you're going to get updates first. I just want you to know, Instagram not going to know no more than what y'all know. I give you all the juice first. Okay. So, now for a pretty plug business tip of the day. I want you all to know that you should not be spending your money before you pray about the different business decisions that you're going to make. The reasons why is because a lot of us function in stimulus, meaning somebody tells us to do something and we just do it. We don't think twice about it. We don't pray about it. We just do it. And right now I'm asking you all, before you respond, before you swipe your card, before you make a business decision, you pray about it. What I have seen in my life is that when I made a decision and I didn't necessarily pray for it, I wound up having to redo that decision, or maybe possibly, you know, regretting that decision or saying, you know what, I just should have thought this through a bit more, right? And the definition of stimulus, meaning it's defined as a thing or an event that evokes a specific functional reaction in an organ or a tissue. And we could just say your mind. So it's equivalent to somebody saying jumping off a bridge and you actually jump off a bridge without thinking. Again, I'm asking you today to think before you spend your money. Think before you make decisions. Think and pray before you make any huge life things. Like, ask, what is God telling you to do? What is He telling you to do before you just go and do something? Before you jump off that bridge, pray about it, please. So, again, that's just one of the business tips. And then the second one is that I encourage each of you all to develop a skill so that you can get paid for it. Whether that be you're a dancer, you're a writer, you're an author, you know how to create podcasts, I'm asking that each of you pick a skill in 2019, master it. Master that skill. And then you can monetize it later on. So that's just a key into my next episode and what we'll be sharing. But first, I need you all to like really go and think and process for 30 minutes and say, what is my skill? What is my job teaching me? What am I learning on this 24 hours that I'm given every single day that God allows me to open my eyes? What can I be learning? What skill can I be mastering? And if you're confused on that, I advise you to take a listen to the 45 other episodes, because there are many skills that we talk about. There are many trades and career paths and entrepreneurial paths that you can review. So again, I'm asking each of you to find a skill. Find something you're passionate about. Become an expert in it. There's nothing better than having a skill. All right. So just going to my next segment that, hey, this is free game I'm giving you. I'm not charging you anything. I want you all to win. I want my circle to win. I want the people that listen to this podcast to win. I want you all to know that this podcast was created with you in mind, meaning we need to share information. Information should not be held in one particular place. It should be global. So when I say that we're spreading information, that means I'm not going to just give you entrepreneurs from Arkansas, from Texas, from Detroit, from California, from Florida. I'm going to give you some information all the way from Gary, Indiana. And this woman, the woman of the hour, that is building a platform to stop gun violence in her community. She is an entrepreneur, a motivational speaker. She has put on and actually given away so many scholarships in her Maryville High School, which is located in Indiana. She's a community activist, and she hosts many women empowerment and or empowerment events. She is a mover and a game changer. And I am so glad that she's on the show. I'm so glad she sent me that DM. You know, some people be trying to get DMs for boobs, but she said, look, I'm trying to get on this podcast. And I'm so happy I answered it and that we were able to get her in on the show. So today's guest is none other than Miss Aaliyah Stewart. Aaliyah, how are you doing today?
I am absolutely amazing, blessed, so grateful to be on the show.
Girl, I'm happy to have you. Like I said, you have inspired me, motivated me. I don't know if any of the guests have went on Google and just Googled your name, because they can find so many videos and just so many things that you've done. And I'm not even going to spill all the tea. I'm going to let you tell them. But one, with our icebreaker, what is a message that you would tell any youth today in order to make sure that they will be successful?
What I would tell the youth is, make sure you leave a legacy and not a reputation. You cannot afford to not be who God called you to be. It's very important to find your purpose and to know your potential. Jeremiah 29:11 talks about potential. So if you don't take anything from this podcast, I pray that you take the fact that you have to walk by faith and not by sight, and stand strong on the vision and the purpose that God has placed inside of you.
Yes, and Aaliyah, you are a leading example of that. You are actually putting forth effort in your visions and your passions. But one, they need to know what your visions and passions are. What is this nonprofit organization you created? What is it founded upon? And girl, can you please tell us how old you are? Because I think that's going to really, really challenge the audience with why they should not be using age as an excuse.
Yes. Well, let me start from here. My name is Aaliyah Stewart, and I'm the proud founder of the ASW Foundation, #IAMTHEM. IAMTHEM means I am my youth, letting them know no matter what you go through or where you come from, you have potential. I started my nonprofit my freshman year of high school at just the age of 14 years old in honor of my two brothers that were killed due to gun violence. Let me tell you, age has nothing to do with it. Not only am I the proud founder of the ASW Foundation, I am also the proud owner of the Next Level Living Nutrition store, located at 6111 Harrison Street in Maryville, Indiana. And I am just 18 years old.
Girl, let me tell you, when she told me, y'all, that she was 18, I said, what? I was just like, at 18, I was thinking about college. I was like, okay, Lord, I'm about to go to college. Like, I'm about to be this engineer. I'm about to do this. Like, I'm moving to Texas. Like, this young lady has developed a career. Aaliyah, you were telling me you dropped out of school. Like, you went and then you have to go back. Like, tell me about that part.
Yes. So I started to go to school in January of 2018. I graduated class of 2018 from Maryville High School, but I finished early, which was November 2017. I said, you know what? I'm going to go to college. I'm going to do what everybody told me to do and go to college, because some people will make you feel like if you don't go to college, you're not going to make it, which is not true. I'm a living testimony from it. So I went to school from January of 2018 and May of 2018. Absolutely, positively did not like it. Got on my knees, prayed and asked God to give me a vision and some resources to go along with it. And I got up and I decided to not go back to school in the fall. But sometimes you move premature. And when I'm saying you move premature, God has placed you in certain situations to where he has supplied the resources to go with your vision, but he needs you to sacrifice some things in order to get to that next level. So I am back in school spring of 2019, and I am taking business administration with a minor in influential speaking to be able to further me later on in life to run into politics.
Wow, girl, listen, are y'all shocked like I am? I'm shook over here as we record this podcast. I am shook. This woman is 18 and she's on it. She is handling her business. Girl, tell me about the people that you got in your circle, because you can't be this great on your own. I know your friends is on another level. Your mentors are on another level. Just tell me about your friend circle.
Well, I always push all of my friends to know that if you cannot fulfill your potential and if you can't see what I see in other people seeing you and what God has inside of you, we cannot be friends. So I push my friends each and every day. I don't want you to be me. I don't want you to be like me. I want you to be better than me. And I feel like you cannot explain a giraffe idea to a turtle, to an elephant, to anything like that. Because if you notice, a giraffe stands tall. An elephant sits short, and a giraffe sits on a whole nother type of level. So I always express to my friends, we have to be able to have like-minded people, but to be able to think outside of the box. I have an absolutely positively amazing, phenomenal mentor, Miss Alexandria Norton, who has been featured on the show before with I Am Beloved. And I'm so grateful to have her because she shapes and grooms me each and every day to be the person that I am.
Yes, girl. Like, I'm so happy you got your mentor now. I feel like I didn't get the mentor that I truly needed until 25. I did have mentors in college, and I'm not saying that they weren't good mentors, but to really push me to where I'm going, my mentor did not come until age of 25. And I'm 24, but I think I'll say 24, but I really feel like I'm 25, but whatever. Also, Aaliyah, I want to talk about some of the events that your organization puts on. Just tell us about like some of the things you do year round and the scholarships that you put on as well.
This past Christmas, December 28th, 2018, I held the second annual ASW Foundation Toy Drive, where I was able to give over 500 children toys for Christmas. I'm so grateful and thankful for everyone in the community that helped with that. Not only do we do events as such, but we go to the intergenerational program at South Shore Nursing Home, and I offer community service. I go out, I have empowerment events. This was my second time having Laying My Legacy, where I teach young ladies to leave a legacy and not a reputation. Along with other things in the community, I am an influential national speaker in this entire United States. So I go around, I share my story and let young women, not just young women, but young men know that you could take a tragedy and turn it into something very powerful with God.
Yes, ma'am. I believe it. I think that you are doing a phenomenal job. I'm over here. I'm your hype beast, girls. And I want everybody to recognize just not only women empowerment, but the fact that this girl is on her stuff and she should be celebrated. Happy Black History Month to you, Aaliyah.
Thank you. Same to you.
Thank you, girl. I just feel like this is amazing. Like, your spirit is amazing. Your goals are amazing. You are on the right foot. But Aaliyah, there was a time where things were not working out. You went through a complete tragic incident where you lost your brother. And this is why that entire organization was founded. So I want you to kind of dive in on what happened in your family a little bit a while ago.
My brother Anthony was killed November 18, 2007. And then I had another tragedy March 18, 2014. My stepbrother, we never did the stepbrother, stepsister thing. That was just my brother. He was killed as well. When my brother Anthony was killed, I was 7. And when James was killed, I was 13. So I've always noticed that with numbers, 7 is the number of completion. Okay, in the Bible, it talks about 7 being the number of completion, and I feel like God moves different chapters in my life. So one day I was sitting at home, December of 2014, and I was talking to God, and I was just saying, you know what, God? I'm ready for you to use me as a living sacrifice. I wanted to be able to help and stand up and talk about gun violence being an epidemic in my community. I just wanted to be able to be that voice for young people and let them know that you can stand up and talk about something that other people want to throw under the rug.
Yeah, and I know it's such, is it still an emotional thing as you journey and, you know, travel state to state to speak on this? Is it still an emotional, like, burden on you, or does it come from a standpoint of you're empowered and you know your brother's legacy is living on through you?
I can say that it's a mixture of both. I have my days where I'm emotional, but I know that God's grace and mercy is sufficient, and He keeps me each and every day. Other days, I'm empowered right now to be able to talk about it and be able to do this interview without crying, without having an emotional hold, because I feel like I made the biggest sacrifice of my life, accepting Christ at a very young age. At 14, I wasn't your average 14-year-old. My freshman year of high school, I wasn't doing things that everyone else was doing because I knew early that God had put a calling and anointing on my life. So when you get to situations as such, you have to format your mind in a spiritual mindset to be able to grasp what God is getting ready to do.
I completely agree. I feel like some people get their challenges and battles earlier, but it's meant for them to be a leader young. And some people may get their challenges a little bit later in life where they wake up and say, I need to find Christ. You know, everybody gets their wake-up calls differently, but it's like when you get your wake-up call, Aaliyah, you could have done so many other things. You could have chosen so many other different ways to take your life, but you chose to live your life being a advocate on behalf of your family. And I want to know, like, did that come from your mom? Did your mom also instill those principles into you? And also, how did y'all handle, like, losing your family member? How did that impact your family?
I can say the greatest gift, I always tell people, the greatest gift my mother gave me was the gift of knowing God. So the blood of God and the blood of Jesus, however some people format it, was instilled in me at a very young age. At 5, I accepted Christ and I knew God for who God was. And I can say that that got my family through it, from my mother to see what she went through. Like I stated previously, over the phone with us, when a husband or a wife loses their spouse, their widow, when a child loses their parent, they're an orphan, but what do you call a mother that has to bear their child? It's not a word to format that feeling, that pain. So for me, I can say to watch my mother go through what she went through, it empowered me to stand strong and to know that if she can get up each and every day and fight it and get up and be able to handle her emotions, who am I to not stand up and stand tall and use what God put us through to make me strong?
Wow. I cannot imagine, you know, what it was like to just lose a family member. But I also want to ask you, like, what were the steps that you took to, like, get through grief? What was the steps you and your family took to get through grief? And also grief with forgiveness, because this wasn't just, you know, somebody just maybe passed away due to an illness. Someone passed away behind a trigger of a gun.
I can say my first step to being able to get through grief is recognizing that you have a problem and understanding that it takes time. You can't jump on it like, oh, I'm going to grieve today, because it could be 3 months from now and you can be able to sit back and be like, oh, I'm having a day because I missed that person. So I can say I've had counselors. I'm still in counseling. I take my time out to myself where I read my Bible. I read the prayer of Jabez.
sit and read my journal. I write in my journal. I draw. I do things. Sometimes I have to become a child to be able to handle my emotions. And I can say, along with dealing with forgiveness, I look at it as God forgives me each and every day for the sins that I commit. And for the young man that killed my brother Anthony, he was 15 years old, a child himself. So at the age of 15, I asked God to give me peace past all understanding, and that's what I have. He will be getting out this year, 2019, and I just want him to take the second chance that God gave him and stand strong and to know that God gave him a second chance and that he can do anything in this world. But the action that he took that night will never be, it can't be recovered. It's not something that we can take back. It's not something that we can go back in the hands of time. Although we may wish to go back and get our loved ones, I'm very grateful for what took place because it has made me the person that I am today.
I love that, Aaliyah. And thank you just for being so bold and sharing with us like what it took for you to, you know, not necessarily forget, but forgiveness and how you got through grief. I am just completely ecstatic at how you've been able to take a tragic moment in your life and turn it. It's like you turn your pain into purpose, literally. You turn your pain into I am them. And just everything surrounding the movements that you created. Now, I also want to ask you about domestic violence and how that has impacted your life and how you're moving forward in that area. I feel like, girl, you've just experienced adversity after adversity after adversity, but it has really made you who you are so that you, when you speak, you don't speak like a 18-year-old. You speak like you 28, 30. Like you got some experience on you, girl. So can you talk to us about the experience you had with domestic violence and encourage these women, encourage and even these men, you know, because they go through domestic violence also. They need to get out of situations that are not going to impact them positively that could potentially be life-threatening.
I can say being a child witness to domestic violence, if you have children, number one, leave because the effect that it has on a child is secondary trauma, which sometimes when you are going through domestic violence situations, you don't notice the effect that it has on your child. You feel as if sometimes it's only affecting you because it's happening to you. But what I realized, and I'm very grateful and thankful that I was blessed to watch my mother go through it because it taught me, number one, how a man is supposed to treat me, and number two, how a man is not supposed to treat me. And it groomed and prepared me for things that I might go out and see in the real world to be able to handle it when it comes to my emotions, to my standpoint with certain situations. So I can say, women, stand stronger to know when a man shows you who they are the first time, believe it. Before you commit yourself to a person, you should know everything about them. You should know their background, where they come from, what they went through. Did they witness domestic violence? Because sometimes the abuser is not doing it because they want to. It's something that they witnessed or they saw as a child, which made them think that, okay, this is how I handle that situation. So I would say to a person that's battling domestic violence, I go out and speak along on the terms of that with the City of Gary, Gary's Commission. The Gary's Commission of Women, where we go out and we take in women that are going through domestic violence, that just got out of a domestic violence situation that is completely tore down. Their spirits are broken. Their self-esteem is gone. So it's very important, before you let a man break you, capture yourself and get down and pray to God, because God will be your savior and he will come in and he will grab you from that situation.
Yes, and we have to know how strong we are. We are so strong, but sometimes, like, I've heard where some women are just like, I can't leave. I love him, you know? Mm-hmm. Did you also see that where it was like, you know, somebody just not being able to walk away because they love that person so much? But love should not hurt.
It shouldn't. And I can say I have seen in certain situations where some women cannot leave due to the love. But what I can say is sometimes God has to break you down before your breakthrough. You have to bend, you have to break before God can get you to your breakthrough. So what I can say in terms of that is, when it comes to domestic violence, before, it's so many different sources. It can be verbal abuse, physical abuse, emotional. It's so many different terms that can be tied into domestic violence. So when you feel that a person has grown to want to control you or grew to trying to make you think that you're this or you're that, that's when you need God the most, because you don't know how strong you are. And so your back is against the wall and you have no choice but to call on God.
Yes, yes, girl. And I also want to share that there is a way out. There is a way out. You don't have to stay in those, you know, painful, physically painful situations, verbally painful. Like, abuse is not just physical. You can be mentally abused as well. Somebody telling you that you're not good enough, that you're not pretty, that you'll never be anything. Like, that is not healthy either. But I want to know, Aaliyah, as you began to mature and just grow, how are you going to prevent yourself from taking the things that you saw in your mom and your stepfather's life without putting it into your future relationship? How are you going to be able to give that new man an opportunity to love despite what you've seen?
I can say, for every time you elevate, God causes a separation in your life. My mom is currently remarried, and her husband now is absolutely amazing. And like I've said, being able to see my mom's new marriage has gave me a spirit of comfortableness, where I'm comfortable to be able to know that there are good men in this world. There are men in this world that know how to treat women, that know how to hold a woman, that knows just how to nurture a woman. And I can say, I won't let it affect me, because when it comes to dating, due to the simple fact that everyone deserves their own chance, they deserve their own walk of life. And I feel that if I hold my guard up, number one, because I'm an anointed child of God, I know God is going to send me somebody that can match my anointing. That's my answer to that question.
Aaliyah said her man gonna match her anointing. She didn't listen. For all the men that's listening out there, y'all better be watching for Aaliyah. This girl is a rock star. And did we say she was 18? Y'all, can you only imagine what you were thinking about at the age of 18 if we got some of our, you know, mature listeners on the phone? So I feel like I'm not old, but I'm like, you know, when I was 18, I wasn't thinking like you're thinking, Aaliyah, at all. And you know, I didn't have mentors. I didn't have the right mentors in my life, I would say. But like, everybody around me was kind of growing and learning, and, you know, in that regard, you know, everybody that's just giving you information. What I learned, and this is just, I'm slightly rambling. Do not take advice from somebody who you wouldn't want to switch shoes with. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's financial advice, relational advice. You know, I won't say that if you're divorced, you know, you can't get information. Like, you can learn something from somebody that's been divorced. One, because they were married and they're not married anymore, so they know what to do and what not to do. But if you're 18 or if you're 25 and, you know, or whatever age, because I don't even think about putting numbers on things. Like, if you want to get to a particular place in your life, you have to choose individuals that will help you get there and that you've seen is already walking and talking in that different way. You know, you can't choose people that look cool, but you're like, when you hear advice, you're like, that don't sound right. 9 times out of 10, if it don't feel right and sound right, then it's probably not right. But Aaliyah, I guess my next question, because I'm done rambling now. What is your next move? I think you told me you're going on a tour. You want to get involved in the politics of Gary, Indiana. Girl, can you tell us, like, what can we look to see you doing in the next year or so?
Yes. Number one, I don't even want to limit myself to what God is getting ready to do in my life. So every night I pray the prayer of Jabez, asking God to enlarge my territory, enlarge my finances. But what I have coming up is a 15 cities, 14 states, and 15 months tour. I'll be touring this entire country.
Wow.
Going out and speaking about my story and sharing the goodness of God. This is all I have on my schedule right now, but we still have people booking, and I'm so grateful and thankful to my publicist, Abundant Life, for setting up this tour. We have that going on. Catch me on your TV screen. That's definitely some things that we're working on that we have coming in. And along with expanding I Am Them and expanding my brand horizon and becoming an activist, not only for gun violence, but for domestic violence as well.
Wow. Girl, I'm going to be watching my TV. In fact, this young lady has been featured on several news stations, and it's just talking about how she's bringing forth the advocacy of eliminating guns and bringing awareness around gun violence in her community. Like, Aaliyah, I can't believe I'm talking to you right now. Like, I feel like I'm talking to a future celebrity that is just, I'm going to be like, oh, I interviewed her. She was on the Wild by Faith show. Like, oh my gosh. Girl, I cannot. Also, with the politics, what is it that you want to be doing there?
Well, I would love to become the mayor of the city of Gary. I would love to get into my number one goal and purpose that I'm working on this year, and I want people to pray for me, not P-R-E-Y, but P-R-A-Y, for me as I get ready to build a youth center in the city of Gary. That is what I'm asking God to send the funding, a full-funded center for me to have in the city of Gary for young people.
Wow. I mean, this whole episode, sometimes I just be like, I amaze myself. I be like, what? God, what is you doing? That's all I be saying. I'm like, Lord, you just bringing all these powerful youth people to the show. I'm like, this has surpassed my wildest dreams. If anybody else is listening, this has surpassed what I ever thought it could be, I must say. But one of my questions to you now is, Aaliyah, what does walking by faith mean to you?
Each and every day I walk by faith and not by sight. I look at things with my spiritual eye and not my natural eye, because eyes have not seen, ears have not heard what God is getting ready to do in the lives of all of us. So I always choose to walk by what God has told me and believe no matter what the natural eye is showing me, I'm trusting in Him. My faith is the size. Matter of fact, my faith's not even the size of a mustard seed. It's bigger than that. Each and every day, I'm trusting in Him. And it was a saying on Instagram like a week ago saying, I'm just out here trusting God. And that's literally me. I'm just out here trusting Him and knowing that He'll make a way out of no way.
Wow. Wow, girl. Today's message comes from Exodus 20:12. I'll be reading from the King James Version. It says, honor thy father and thy mother, that thy days may be long upon the Lord, which the Lord thy God giveth thee. All right, so that was a long way of saying you need to follow your instructions of your parents. If you're out here, I won't say in these streets, but probably for anybody that's listening to this podcast, you may not be experiencing anything with gun violence. But if you see youth out here, and if you know that you can be showing them the light, if you're not a mentor to somebody, you need to become one, a mentor. If you see somebody going down the wrong path, kindly show them the better route. And also, if you are the youth, I know I have several people from high school and college that listen to this podcast, do the right thing. Your life is too important. It can be taken away from you. It's nothing to play with. Your life is nothing to play with. And at any time and at any age, it can be gone. So that's why it's so important for one, for you to take that next step and follow Christ, for you to get involved in a church home, for you to choose to spend your nights wisely, find positive things to do. You don't always have to be in the club and out there in the streets, because sometimes those things are not safe. But Aaliyah, where can the people find you on social media? Because they need to find who you are. They do.
Yay! You can follow me on Instagram at hope_ASW, Facebook at hope_ASW. If you would like to purchase an I Am Them shirt or just donate to the ASW Foundations, all donations are tax deductible. You can go on IAMTHEM.org, IAMTHEM.org.
Girl, it was such a pleasure having you on the show today. You are just an inspiration. I feel like every trial, everything that you've gone through, girl, you are turning your pain into purpose. And I feel like you said your favorite song was My Testimony. Yes. And that's going to be playing in the beginning and at the end of this episode, because to be honest, your testimony is amazing. Everything that you all heard today was someone's testimony saying, hey, I lost my first father. I lost my brother. My mom experienced domestic violence. I have gone through trials in my life, but I stood back up every single time. And if you are listening to this podcast and you are feeling down and you're like, I don't have anywhere else to go, I don't have anywhere else to turn, do you know that when you stand on Christ, He will deliver you. He will give you the strength that you need. He will be everything that you need to keep going and keep fighting. Don't take your life. Don't think suicidal thoughts. If you're having anxiety and depression, seek a counselor. But you do not have to walk away or end your life early or put yourself in negative situations because you think that life is getting too hard. Aaliyah just said, hey, my life was challenging. I did go through some things. I lost a lot of people, but I'm still here and I'm still fighting. Do you agree, Aaliyah?
Yes, I do. It's God's grace.
Yes. Girl, listen. I'm excited. This episode has been absolutely amazing. I'm walking away saying I am them. I feel like it. I am them. I'm going to get my shirt. I'm going to donate because y'all know I love to, you know, support my people. It is Black History Month. It is Black History Month. If you all can't find anybody to support, support Aaliyah. You see that she is trying to do something with gun violence in her community. I urge you to support a Black-owned business every Friday of the year. Black Friday every year, not just during Black History Month, but every Friday. And then once you develop that concept, I ask you to change your bathroom. Is that black? Is all the products black? Okay, if your bathroom isn't black, now let's go to the kitchen. Now let's start the transition so that we are supporting our brothers and sisters all around the world so we can circulate the black dollar. Aaliyah, thank you for your presence. Thank you for
thank
your beautiful
you for
spirit.
Me.
You're so welcome. You're so welcome. And I wish you the best as you are continuing to travel around this world. Get you some sleep, girl. I know you got your vitamins from your business. I know you got that going. But get you some rest. And, girl, just keep pushing and keep working. And I can't wait to see you on my TV screen.
Thank you so much. Same with you. God is getting ready to elevate you to a level you could have never imagined.
Girl, yeah, I feel it. I'm over here praying like, Lord, keep me. But I know he will. But thank you, Aaliyah. And thank you all that listen week after week. This has been another episode on the Walk by Faith Show. We'll see you next week.
If you want more content like this, make sure you give the Walk by Faith podcast a 5-star rating and leave a review on Apple Podcasts. You can follow me on Instagram at __thePrettyPlug and follow all updates on the podcast at wbfpodcast. To those already supporting the show with a monthly subscription, thank you. If you're not already a supporter and you'd like to help make this show possible, tap the link in this episode's description or visit anchor.fm/jasmine-a-stiff to become a monthly supporter. That's all, folks. Tune in next week for another episode on the Walk by Faith Show.